Liebe Frau Steinbeck, verehrte Damen und Herren.
When you turn to the left or right, you will see 6 portrait canvases on the upper wall. The work Day and Night Times by the visual artist Ulrich Erben. We also already had the pleasure to listen to some musical works. The reception of fine arts and music is linked to one sensory modality respectively, seeing and hearing. There are many hybrid forms of visual and auditory arts, for example, the opera or the ballet. In Western art, at any rate, great importance is attached to the visual and to the auditory senses. The so-called chemical senses are rarely appealed to in the art world, smelling and tasting. If you are now thinking of the classical 5 Aristotelian senses, what remains, next to the senses of sight and hearing, smell and taste, is the sense of touch. Another sense treated rather dismissively in the Western art world. Concerning the immediacy with which it allows us to experience our own body, the sense of touch is close to another sensory modality, which I want to take into focus today, namely proprioception. Proprioception, that is the inner perception of our own body's movements in space, or the inner perception of the position of our body parts to each other. Also counted as proprioception are the sense of balance, muscle tone, the sensation of pain, itching, warmth, of our energy and stress levels, our heartbeat, the intensity of breathing, etc. What I am interested in here and in my research is whether there are or can be works of art which take the appeal to proprioception, that is, the perception of our own body's movements and the processes taking place within it, into focus. And this focus is what is important to me here. As corporal, physical beings, we are, of course, permanently accompanied by our body. When you were looking at the canvases and you moved your torso, your shoulders, your neck, surely did you feel your own body. But despite your body self-perception while looking at Ulrich Erben's works, these pictures are just as little proprioceptive works of art as they are transformed into musical works of art just because you casually heard something while looking at them. There are some arts that make use of proprioception. Dance, the fluxus movement, happenings, performance, etc. And Ted Shawn, a pioneer of modern dance, said, "Dance is the only art wherein we ourselves are the stuff in which it is made." Yet it could be that Shawn was just saying this. The dancers on stage constitute the material of art for the audience, in the same sense as the canvas and the acrylic are the material for the pictures up there. I'm concerned with something else, a radical turn to our own inner being. Therefore, I define a proprioceptive work of art as follows. First, it has to be a performance, a physical practice, whose primary or only focus is our own body perception. And, second, this bodily practice must be classified as art. Otherwise, I only have proprioception, but no work of art. Candidates for one, those physical practices, are yoga and the Asian martial arts. They certainly meet the first criterion. They are practices of self-awareness of the body. You can also feel your own body on trampolines, slides and safety nets. But can that be art? How to define art philosophically anyway? Which objects or which human activities are considered as art? There's unfortunately not much agreement in philosophy of art yet. But I think that no matter what theory one holds, I can give good reasons why various body practices are proprioceptive art. Here, I have listed exemplary some philosophical art theories. I can only go into detail about institutionalism, though, which roughly claims that a work of art is, first, an artifact, a performance, a practice, Second, to which a museum, a curator, a gallery owner conferred the status of an object of aesthetic appreciation by exhibiting it. For my purposes, therefore, a relevant institution must have recognized that a primarily proprioceptively experienced practice is worthy of aesthetic perception and appreciation. Then this practice or installation, according to institutionalism, is art. You will now rightly ask yourself, what kind of museum does that? Does that exist? And the answer to this question is yes.
Und die Beispiele.
And the examples have been accumulating lately, even though they do not yet bear the label proprioceptive art. Here's a trampoline by William Forsythe and others. Here are some slides by Carsten Höller at Tate Modern. And of course, you all know Saraceno's installation In Orbit at the K21, where you can feel your sense of balance, your muscle tone while balancing, your heartbeat and breathing, and you may get hot flushes or be in cold sweat. And all this is intended. The curators write on the museum's website, "Seldom does a work of art aim so directly at the fear and pleasure of the viewers when they dare to take the decisive step into the airy heights." Saraceno's web is like an instrument that is there to let it ring out proprioceptively within us. Some future research questions ask themselves, is the net the work of art then? Or is it the individual bodily experience you have? Or the instruction to get into the net? These are art ontological questions. And bear in mind, for a purely proprioceptive work of art, a work of art you experience inwardly, you are both the performer and necessarily your own and only audience. Only you yourself can feel your body from the inside. But then the question is pending, how is proprioceptive art intersubjectively communicable? Proprioceptive art, although not yet under this name, is, as we have seen, currently highly valued in the art world. However, there is still much to be done on the philosophical classification and theoretical conceptualization as proprioceptive art. These are some of the questions my future research will address. And if I have awakened your interest in proprioceptive art, then I'm very much looking forward to future discussions. This talk was given at the President's New Year's Reception 2020 at Heinrich Heine University in Düsseldorf. It was addressed to the wider public, not to a philosophical audience of specialists. I wish you a good proprioceptive time.
Und nun wünsche ich Ihnen ein propriozeptives neues Jahr 2020.